a lot of the jobs that people took during COVID, we make the assumption that they wanted to work for us when they took the job during COVID. In the reality is some people took the job because it was a job during COVID. And in their own minds, it was never supposed to be permanent. You know, maybe some of them fell in love, but as soon as the market opened up, their intention was always to leave. So we can't completely beat ourselves up if we do lose some people. But I think a lot of people they're bouncing. They're trying things. I mean, let's be realistic. A lot of young people move back home, so their bills are lower, so they can afford to wait and hang out. I think the gig economy is a real thing. And what Uber and those companies, they built into the vernacular this idea of a gig economy. And I think people really fancy being freelancers. Yeah. Maybe even freelance servers. That I work for three hotels because I want to pick up shifts here that suit me.
Beehive.
And what does the gig economy mean in traditional employment? Yeah. I think that's a big part of it, to be honest. But I think a lot of people are also recognizing that money is less important to them than their relationships and their experiences. And I think people are okay making less. So they may have cut or stabilized their incomes and they maybe don't have that crazy ambition. The thing that I fear, and we touched upon this before, which is people are less afraid of quitting now, young people are less afraid of quitting, and they're building the gig economy lives for themselves. My fear is that they're gonna go from job to job to job. When we were younger, you couldn't quit a job in less than 1 year because it would look bad on your resume, right? Now, 3 months, whatever, goodbye. You know? And my fear is, flash forward 5 years, one of two things will definitely happen. An employer will look at you that in 5 years you've had 9 jobs. I'm not gonna hire you because I just can't trust that you're gonna stick around. And you've had 9 jobs in 5 years, you haven't been around anywhere long enough to go through a cycle of good times and bad times, and so you have no discernible skill set. And my fear is that what feels great now, it's gonna have consequences in a few years. I'm worried about that, and I don't know how to communicate that in a way that is sticky. You know, I'm talking about eating healthy now so you don't get diabetes in 20 years. I mean, you know, it's hard, that's a hard message for people to stick, but I'm worried about that.